Hey, welcome to Coffee and Devotions. This Monday morning is, January 25th. This is where every weekday morning at 9 a.m. Well, that's not true anymore. It's just generally at 9 a.m. you and I, we get together, we get into God's Word, and we grow in our love for the Lord together. And this year, 2021, we will make it through all of the wisdom literature. Well, this morning we are at Psalm 16. Psalm 16. Why don't we go ahead and have some coffee? We'll pray and we'll get into God's Word. Hey, amen. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for this day, and we pray now that as we read your word, that you would bless us. Please care for us. Let us follow after you and love you with all of our hearts. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, here we go. Psalm 16. Preserve me, O God, for I put my trust in you. O my soul, you have said to the Lord, you are my Lord. My goodness is nothing apart from you. As for the saints who are on the earth, they are the excellent ones in whom is all my delight. Their sorrows shall be multiplied who hasten after another God. Their drink offerings of blood I will not offer, nor take up their names on my lips. O Lord, you are the portion of my inheritance and my cup. You maintain my lot. The lines have fallen to me in pleasant places. Yes, I have a good inheritance. I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel. My heart also instructs me in the night seasons. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Therefore, my heart is glad. My glory rejoices. My flesh will also rest in hope. For you will not leave my soul in Sheol, nor will you allow your Holy One to see corruption. You will show me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures evermore. Well, what a beautiful passage. We need to say, what is this about? What are we called to do? And what's the best verse, right? So what is this passage about? This passage is about rejoicing in God and all that God has done and will do. It's God who is the psalmist. This is David. It's God who is David's portion. It's God who's David's cup. It's God who is going to preserve him. It's God who is not going to allow him to see decay. It is God who is wonderfully caring for David. So what is this about? This is rejoicing in who God is and what God has done. What's the best verse to summarize this? Well, I think in my Bible here, that's going to be a really hard one. You know, I think I might, actually, I've already done this in my Bible. So in my Bible, I have, what verse is that? Verse 2 underlined there. So, O my soul, you have said to the Lord, you are my Lord. My goodness is nothing apart from you. It's God who's our Lord. What are we called to do? We're called to rejoice. He's not going to abandon us in the grave, but there is a resurrection. He hasn't let Jesus Christ see corruption, but he has risen up and has ascended into heaven, and Jesus sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. And if he has done that with Jesus, he will also do that with us. We know that we will rise again from the dead. Jesus has not seen corruption, and he is the firstborn of the resurrection. What are we called to do? To count God as our portion, to see God as our inheritance, to rejoice in the Lord, to trust in the Lord, to hope in Jesus Christ. This is the beauty of the gospel in the book of Psalms, is that my soul, you have said to the Lord, you are my Lord. My goodness is nothing apart from you. I pray that today you might find rest and joy in God, not just the things of this world that always leave you wanting, but that you might find rest and joy and fulfillment in God himself. Let's pray. God, we thank you so much for this day. We thank you for this time in the morning to spend in your word. We pray that you would care for us and bless us this day. Let us rejoice in you and in your goodness. In Jesus' name, amen. May the Lord bless you today. May you go with peace, and I'll see you tomorrow morning. Bye.